as the days go along here, more and more happening in agriculture. Some pretty big stories, some pretty big topics to talk about on today's edition of the Farm Report here on Rise and Shine with Harry Siemens, brought to you by Wolf Enterprises. Harry, joining the show from the comfort of his home, as always, on this Wednesday morning. Harry, hey. How's it going? How you doing on this Wednesday morning? Man?
You know what? Very good. Just you were talking about the Grey Cup. And my first Grey Cup I watched on television in Plump Cooley on Hank's TV set, 1954. And I did a history of what happened on that, and I remember some of the things. And so that was my first Grey Cup that I watched on television. I watched and attended a couple in person myself. So congratulations to the Winnipeg Blue Bombers and all their fans. And it's great to see.
Yeah, and I'm a huge Winnipeg Blue Bomber fan, so it was nice to see the blue and gold go out and take home the cup for the second consecutive Grey Cup, as they did go back-to-back, Harry, which is just awesome to see after the huge drought that the Bombers had of about, I think it was 29 or 30 years since, you know, when they first won the Grey Cup back in 2019. To do it again, well, it was awesome and special to see how that group came out and persevered. But let's get into agriculture.
Yeah, you bet.
You know, a big story, I feel like a big issue, I think like a lot of issues could arise in this, is truckers choosing not to be vaxxed with a new vaccine mandate coming in. Fill us in on what's happening there.
Yes, as of January, and you know what, there was a slight reprieve for people like you and me that are vaccinated as well, that can go into the United States. I just saw a release out of the federal government that now that's changed again too, because of the new variant supposedly. So, but getting into the truckers thing, there's about 22,000 truckers that could well be walking off the job as of January the 1st or January, whenever that date will be, because they're the ones that have not been vaccinated and they cannot go into the United States and come back. And so that's a totally different change. You know, I was involved in a Field and Wheels transportation conference with the University of Manitoba just a couple of days ago. And I asked a few questions of some of the speakers and what this will do. And the first and foremost is that, you know what, we're going to see increases in rates, because a lot of the border crossing trucking companies are simply not going to have drivers to take the freight across. So what happens? You start to increase freight rates. And that's all we need for our products. I mean, we've got, you know, supply chain problems already. And if this comes into effect, as far as agriculture is concerned, a lot of our grain moves right from the farmer's farm to the United States. And the grain moves from trucks. And the other thing I heard from the transportation conference, which are really a focus on rail traffic, that the rail industry, and we're seeing this merger between Kansas City Rail and CP Rail, that's going to improve rail traffic right from Canada to Mexico. And so on one hand, it'll increase the rates for using trucks to transport any of the product. And we're talking farm machinery. We're talking fertilizer. We're talking grain. We're talking all kinds of supplies. And that is going to be a real challenge, because if truckers aren't driving, the trucks are standing. And a lot of those trucks are driver-owner. What they do, right, they work for a company. And I know I have two truckers that I follow closely. I've become very good friends in the United States. One got the vaccination. He's going to continue to travel. The other one says, I'm parking my truck. And so, and that's going to happen with a lot of companies. There may well be some trucking firms that may not even be driving. You know, they may shut down temporarily until some things happen. So number one, It's a rate increase. Number two, the supply chain that we've been hearing about, talking about, is going to tighten. I mean, we've got hogs going from, they don't get on a train. They have to be trucked to the United States. And so that's all kinds of things that are playing in this whole thing. I mean, once you get into processed pork, well, then of course you start using containers and train and so forth. But no, it's a real issue as far as the supply chain and increase in rates are concerned. And I just saw on Twitter before I came on that those rates have already increased. And so, yeah, it's going to be a real challenge.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Just something that you hate seeing happen because of, people's stances on the vaccine. Unfortunate that it's going to come down to this, to where a bunch of truckers are just going to, stand up and say, I'm not going to do this. And then going to affect the supply chain. And like you said, Harry, the rates are going to go up as well. So you'll definitely keep us updated on this story as, it continues to develop here in the upcoming weeks on Rise and Shine Manitoba. But something that you mentioned to me right before we started off was China, the tariffs on pork imports. Give us an update on, what's that all about?
Well, China, you never quite know for sure where they're at. And the news coming out of China, is it factual or is it set? Is it coming out of China to influence the market? Because when you have 1.3 billion people to feed, that means a lot of product. And so the Chinese have been known to put out messages that will bring the price of products down. We ship some pork and that go to China, especially a couple of companies. And the United States, of course, ships a lot of pork to China. And so whatever happens in the United States as far as the price is concerned, that price is basically reflected to us here in Canada. And one of the things that's kept the Canadian hog producers up a little bit as far as the profits and prices concerned is the dollar. When our dollar drops, and because the price is set in the United States and a lot of the product goes there, well, our price drops, the price of pork increases here in Canada, right? And so right now, the Chinese have said we're going to up the tariffs on frozen pork coming into China from 8% to 12%. A while back, because they were in short supply because of African swine fever, and we've talked about that in the past, yeah, they dropped it from 12% to 8% because they needed pork. Well, they've had a chance to revitalize their industry, and someday I want to talk about it. I'll mention it briefly. China builds 5-story, 6-story high hog barns. I saw a picture of one out of Russia. And so the hog industry in China is trying to revitalize after losing 40% of their pigs through African swine fever. So now they've got more product. The price in China has dropped. So they're putting on a tariff going from 8% to 12% on frozen pork. And so that less pork will come into China because their prices dropped. Their prices will then be coming up. So it's really interesting. I have a representative, a very good friend, I've talked to him about him here before, Dr. John Carr. Dr. John Carr is an international livestock veterinarian consultant. And he's a consultant to various hog producers in Canada, especially a number of the Hutterite colonies. And I've met John since 2012, probably 2-3 times a year, except I haven't since COVID started, right? He used to come 4 times a year to Canada. Right now he lives in Australia. So we get together via Skype or Zoom, and he lets me know. When I see something like this happen, immediately I fire it off to John. and he's become a real personal friend. It's been awesome. And I know that John doesn't mess around with things. He's responsible for feeding 150,000 sows that, you know, in China. And he feeds pigs in probably 9 countries around the world. And that doesn't mean he personally does it. He oversees the health and welfare of the pigs. And he also is very keen on cost of production. So I'm waiting for John to fire something back to me, and we'll have that on the show next week. But I'm also been bugging him. You know, we haven't talked for a couple of months just because he's been so busy with things, doing what he's doing. So anyway, we're going to get in touch with him there. But, you know, the pig business right now in Canada, you know, we've talked about the prices. The feed prices are so high. The hog prices are relatively high. And so there's a margin. But if the feed prices don't come down and the hog prices do, then we know what happens as far as profits are concerned in the pig business. And right now in Canada, and I mentioned this before, the hog industry is worth $25 billion. That's with a B. $1 billion across Canada. And, you know, and so that's a huge industry. That includes, you know, from gate to plate, right? You know, from the producer to when you and I pick up a piece of pork and eat it. We've got the big processors in Quebec, Ontario. We've got 2 big ones here in Manitoba between High Life and Maple Leaf in Brandon. High Life's in Neepawa. And then we have another one, Ole Mill, up in Red Deer, Alberta, and then a number of smaller ones in between. So the hog industry, you know, we talked about it last week. I mean, they didn't fill 50% of their positions last year that were available because there just aren't people available, and especially during this whole COVID time. So, hey, there's a little lesson on the hog business. And somebody says, well, how come you know so much? Well, he says, if I haven't learned something in 50 years, I mean, I should be getting out of the business, right?
Yeah, right, for sure. About John, you know, hopefully he's enjoying his time in the land down under, and hopefully he fires you a text back soon, Harry, since you guys haven't talked.
Oh, totally. He will.
And, yeah, he will. And at some point here, hopefully soon, so we got some updates on, you know, what's happening over there. But let's end off the show today, Harry, by, you know, one of my favorite things. Hearing your farming tip of the week for farmers on Harry Siemens, farming tip of the week here on Rise and Shine.
Yeah, the farming tip of the week is basically has to do with the transportation industry. I mean, we've got problems still going west with rail and with rail and truck because of the storms in British Columbia, and that's still, you know, it's still there. They're cleaning up. So the farming tip of the week is basically look after your freight. I mean, a lot of farmers have their own trucking companies, but if they aren't vaxxed, they can't haul their product across the border. So it's going to be a real time to consider all kinds of things about how you're going to move your product. Because one thing, the freight prices rise and the supply management, and so the prices may well come down as far as grain prices are concerned. So check out your freight. If you need to haul product across the border, make sure you do your homework before you leave the country.
Yeah, for sure. Always do your research. Always a good lesson to take in and to put it into practice, and it can be so important, especially what's going on with transportation right now. You know, for truckers going over the border. Harry Siemens on this week's edition of the Farm Report here, brought to you by Wolf Enterprises. Harry, always a pleasure, and I'm pretty sure next week is the last show of the year. I'm not too sure yet, but for sure, we'll see you next week on Wednesday, man. You take care.
Perfect. Yeah.
And Harry Siemens, the man,